Welcome to a lesson on arithmetic sequences. The goals of this video are to determine the nth term of an arithmetic sequence, determine the common difference, and also to determine the formula of an arithmetic sequence. As we learned in the previous video, an arithmetic sequence is a sequence that has a pattern of adding a constant to determine consecutive terms. And we can say that arithmetic sequences have a common difference. So if we take a look at this sequence down here and look for a pattern, what we'll notice is that there's a pattern of adding 4 to obtain the next term in the sequence. And so because the pattern stays consistent of adding a constant, this is an arithmetic sequence. And what we'll notice is we can find the common difference from this formula by selecting any term in the sequence and subtracting the term before it. So if we use a sub 2, we would subtract a sub 1. Negative 1 minus negative 5 will give us positive 4. If we want to use the fifth term in the sequence, we would have to subtract the fourth term. 11 minus 7 also equals positive 4. This next formula, a sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times the common difference, you might be thinking, why the n minus 1? Well, if you take a look at the sequence again and look at the pattern, notice the second term we added 4 one time. The third term we would add 4 two times, and the fourth term we would add 4 three times. So we'll always add n minus 1 multiples of the common difference to the first term to get any other term in the sequence. And this last formula here is a recursive formula, which just means if we want to find, let's say, the fifth term, we just take the fourth term, a sub n minus 1, and then add the common difference. And this is just emphasizing the pattern that we see here in red. Let's go ahead and see if we can answer some questions using arithmetic sequences. Again, as we stated in the previous video, a sequence is a function, so we can identify the domain and the range. And what's helpful to determine the domain and range is to label each term as a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, a sub 4, a sub 5, and lastly a sub 6. So the values of n represent the domain. So the domain of this sequence will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And the range of the sequence would be the actual elements in the list. And we usually list these from least to greatest, so we'll list the range as negative 6, negative 3, 0, 3, 6, and 9. Okay, on this problem, we're given the formula for the arithmetic sequence. We want to determine the first three terms and then the eighth term. So we want to find a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, and a sub 8. So if we want a sub 1, that means n is equal to 1. So we have negative 4 times 1 plus 3, that's negative 1. A sub 2, that means n is equal to 2. Negative 4 times 2 plus 3. Negative 8 plus 3 is equal to negative 5. A sub 3, so n is 3. We have negative 12 plus 3, that's negative 9. And the eighth term, that means n is equal to 8, negative 4 times 8 plus 3. We have negative 32 plus 3, that's negative 29. So the sequence would look like this, negative 1, negative 5, negative 9, and then the eighth term would be negative 29. They also asked us to state the common difference. Remember, to find the common difference, we just select one term and then subtract the term before it. So if we use a sub 2, the common difference will be negative 5 minus a sub 1, which is negative 1. So we have negative 5 plus 1, so the common difference is negative 4. And we can see this sequence is decreasing by 4 each time because we're adding negative 4 each time. Let's go and take a look at this question now. We're given that it's an arithmetic sequence. We want to determine the formula for the sequence and then also determine the 12th term. To determine the formula for the sequence, we're going to have to determine the formula for a sub n as we see here. So we're going to have to find a sub 1 and also the common difference to use this formula. So let's go ahead and write this out. A sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. A sub 1 is the first term, so a sub 1 equals negative 2. And to determine the common difference, we're going to select any term and then subtract the term before it. So if I wanted to use the term here that's equal to 12, the common difference would be 12 minus the term before it, or 8.5. So the common difference is equal to 3.5. Remember, I can obtain the common difference by selecting any term and subtracting the term before it. So if I wanted to use this term here, 1.5 minus negative 2 is still going to equal 3.5. Now that we have a sub 1 and d, we can substitute those values into the formula and find a sub n. So a sub n equals negative 2 plus n minus 1 times the common difference of 3.5. Now this is the formula to determine any term in the sequence, but normally we'll be asked to simplify this, so we'll distribute 3.5 and then combine any like terms. So we'll have a sub n equals negative 2 plus 3.5n minus 3.5. Here we have two like terms. So our formula will be a sub n equals 3.5n minus 5.5. One more thing to notice here, if you take a look at the coefficient of the n term, it is equal to the common difference. We were also asked to determine the 12th term, so using this formula, we'll let n equal 12 to find that 12th term. Let's go ahead and do that on the next screen. So here's the formula that we had on the previous screen. So a sub 12 will equal 3.5 times 12 minus 5.5. Well, 3.5 times 12, that'll be 42 minus 5.5, which equals 36.5. So the 12th term is equal to 36.5. Okay, that'll do it for this video. Next, we'll take a look at geometric sequences.